Hello everybody, I'm David from Automate This. I created a recent video where we looked at what happens if you send a single piece of data through a workflow and then pushed it through an if node and a switch node. And if you saw that video, you will see that it branched the workflow based on whether the condition we set was true or false, or in the switch node, the condition that we set. Now, because there was only a single piece of data, it meant that the workflow would only branch in one of two different directions with the if node, or one of whatever direction based on the condition. In today's video, we're going to take a look at what happens if you send multiple data through the workflow and push that data through an if node and a switch node. And you'll see that it works in a very different way, but it's also an incredibly effective way at filtering or splitting data and allows you to run multiple branches based on the condition set in the if node and the switch node. Let's take a look at what happens if we send multiple data through the workflow and into an if node and a switch node. So for my example today, I'm going to be using a manual trigger just to fire off my workflow. But based on the examples that you see today, you might use something like a schedule trigger or a get request. And to bring the data into my workflow, I'm going to be using an Airtable node. Now I've got this all set up and ready to go, and it's just going to pull in some fake order data. So I'm going to run test step on this, and you can see that this request pulls in 15 different items based on things like salesperson, last name, email address, etc., etc. And if we go back to the canvas, you can now see that there are 15 items coming out of the Airtable node. If you saw that previous video when we used the if and switch node, you'll remember that there was only one item. And that one item was going to branch off depending upon whether, in the case of the if node, the condition was true or false, and the switch node was based on a department that the person had contacted. But now we've got 15 different items that are now coming through the workflow. So let's see what happens now then if we were to add an if node into the workflow. Now I'm going to base this condition firstly on whether or not the payment received here is yes or no. So I'm going to drag in the payment received into the first value to check. And I'm going to run this against a test for yes, the payment is received. That's going to be my true condition. And of course, the false condition is going to be no. And if I test this step, what you will now see happen is 8 items go down the true branch and 7 items go down the false branch. So it'll take all of the data that you feed into the if node and branch it now based on whether it's true or false, but it will send all of the true items down one branch and all of the false items down the other. And if we now go back to the canvas, we can see this represented by 8 items going down the true branch and 7 items going down the false branch. What happens when you've got multiple datas running through your workflow is the workflow will run both the true and the false branch. So it's going to do whatever you set up for the true branch, and it's also going to do whatever you set up for the false branch. Now, in this example, if the payment has been received, I don't want anything to happen. You might want to send an email or something like that, but for this example, I'm going to leave the true branch alone, and I only want to work with my false branch. And what I would like to do is to send an email to these customers where payment hasn't been received. So I'm going to use my SMTP node or send email node here. Now, I'm not going to set all of this up for the example, but if you have this and you've got it configured with credentials, then great. But essentially what I'm going to do then is to drag in the email address into the to email. I'm going to set up my, let's say, admin at company.com address. Let's say the subject line here is your order still requires payment. And in the HTML, I'm going to say hello. I'm going to use an expression here. So hello, first name. Actually, let's just put some HTML around this as well to make it all format correctly. So these paragraphs here. Let's put your order number, reference. Let's pull the order number into here. Still requires a payment of, and then the order value, and we can keep going with that essentially. Let's see, wrap that in paragraphs as well. Okay, great. So I've got that all set up, ready to go. It's not going to send anything because I don't have credentials. But what will happen is, because there are 7 items coming into this SMTP or send email node, it will run that node for each of the 7 items. That means that each of these 7 customers that are in the table now are going to receive an individual email with the data that we have just placed in there. If you also wanted to do the same for the true node, you could, but you would just change the email or set up whatever you want to set up. But when you run the workflow from that point, it will go through the Airtable node, it will branch out in the if node, and run it in this case for 8 items for the true node and 7 items for the false node. So what happens when you send multiple data versus single data is it will run both the true branch and the false branch if there are data in both of them. Okay, let's back this up then, take out the if node and see what happens if we add in a switch node. Okay, so for my switch node, I want to create branches based on the salesperson in the data that we have received. So I'm going to drag in my salesperson as my value 1. And let's say we set the example here to Alex, who's the first person in the list. Rename this to Alex to make it easier to remember. Next, we're going to pull in Mario. And rename that to Mario. And I have 6 salespeople in my list here. To make this easier, I have created these already, so I'm just going to pull in the full switch node. See what it looks like. So I have all 6 of my salespeople in this list now, with their outputs as their name. And if I was to test this step, you can now see that it creates these 6 individual branches with the number of items that are relevant to each one of those team members. And if we click back out to the canvas, we can now see the items going down these 6 individual branches. Now, like the if node, if we were to run the workflow, it will run all 6 branches, or will run every branch with data in it. So depending upon how you configure each of those 6 branches, it would run all 6 of them in this case. So let's say, for example, I wanted to total the sales value for each of these team members. I could add in a summarize node. Set this to sum. And then drag in the order value, for example, for this. And if I test this step, We're currently working with Alex, so this is Alex's total sales. And once I've got that in place, I might want to email Alex with that information. So I'm going to send an email. Again, I've got no credentials set up in here, but say it's from salesmanager@company.com. I'm going to send this to alex@company.com. Your sales totals. I'm going to use HTML format, so I'm going to put hi Alex, and let's go with your sales totals for last week were, let's put a pound sign in there. I'm still going to put this exactly where I want it, but I can tidy it up a little bit. We just check this out. So this is now going to send, hi Alex, your sales totals for last week were, and here's the value. And again, if we were to test this step, it would send that email to Alex, but I have no credentials, so it's not going to work. So that's what it looks like for Alex. If I wanted then to do the same for everybody, I can just copy and paste these two nodes. Let's connect that to Mario. Run this test. That's Mario sales. And I need to pop back into here then and change this to Mario and Mario. And if I was to run the workflow as is now, that would run down those two branches and would send an email to Alex and to Mario. And if I configured all six of them in the same way, it would do exactly the same for all six of them. So you can see now, when you send multiple data down a workflow using an if node and a split node, it will branch off all of those data based on the conditions that you set, and it'll run both the true and false branch in an if node, or multiple different branches in a switch node, depending upon how you configure it. Meaning it's really good for filtering data or splitting data and then configuring it exactly how you want based on the conditions that you set. I hope you found this short video useful. If you did, don't forget to like and subscribe to the channel, and I will see you in another video real soon. Thanks for now.